fresh from taking over the entire festival yesterday. He has recovered this morning, and I'm delighted to bring you our second TV dinner of the week. Please welcome The Complete Another World with Mr. Eric Chahi.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so I will play the game from the beginning to the end, and I've decided to play it with the original resolution in 300 by 220 by 200 in 16 color. And yes. So this scene has been rotoscoped. I use the rotoscoping technique, but not so much in the game, mainly for the introduction and the main character when he's walking or running. It's not in the introduction, the serum. So this has been rotoscoped, for example. Can you put the volume? Yes, thank you. The whole game is an improvisation. At the beginning of the creation, I did not know how it will end. And first, I create the introduction, and that's it. And mainly because I had to create some tool before, and because I wanted to prove myself that the two were okay, so I really focus on the introduction to really put the player into the atmosphere of the game, but myself too. So at that point, I do not know absolutely what would be happen next. And so I decided, I teleport this guy into another world, but which, I don't know. And where should I teleport it? Into the air. And I decided, wow, underwater, it should be really crazy. Because there is a lot of teleportation in some movie, but appearing underwater is very unusual and unearthly. So the whole game, the graphics are made of polygons, but I was tempted to use some pixel, and because the game I did before was done with, I did the graphics with Deluxe Paint, and it used a traditional bitmap. And so at the beginning of the creation, I really wanted to add many details. And for example, on the top of the on the left, you can see many pixels for the reflection of the sun on the rock. And oops, yeah. And that was very laborious to create, because all the graphics are done with Polygon, with a tool I have designed. And each pixel is a very small polygon. So it took a very long time. And later in the game, you will see that there is less pixel. And some picture has been done entirely in bitmap. There is probably 7-8 bitmap in the game. But the game is mainly made of polygon, and it was mainly to win some memory, because at the time, well, on Amiga, we have a very low memory, and it was not possible to have big animation and big graphics easily as today. And polygon, which is made of flat color and some of and shape, use very low memory. And the introduction, how many kilobytes do you think that the introduction you saw before took? 200? More? More or less?
Lower.
How many?
50.
50? Ah, 84. Okay. So you can see the beast in the background, and in this game, I use a lot of. I wanted to suggest a story, so I use different things like parallel action. So when there is the black beast in the background, is an action that suggests something for the player, and that will become real later. So there is some punctuation, cinematic punctuation, and it's really short. Yes. In this game, the death is central. It's really a tough world, and it's a part of the experience. Another kind of punctuation. So I play a lot with the pacing, with slow pacing and acceleration, because I really wanted to have a movie feeling, not to create exactly a movie, but bring in a game the pacing of a movie. So I play with a player expectation, trying to surprise him. The close-up you saw before of the friend, it's the only close-up in the game, and indeed I think it is well memorized by the player, and it helped him to structure it construct the perception of the whole world of the game. So now, by seeing a small character like this, he can project this face in through his imagination. This game let a lot of place to player imagination, from the way the story is tell to the graphics, which are minimalism, and even the language. Another kind of cinematic punctuation. And there is foreground animation here. Whoops. The game has been designed chronologically, and at that point I introduced the weapon, the fact that a weapon can create a single shot, a shield, and a big ball of energy to destroy a wall. The fact is, this idea came because first, I wanted the player to be able to hide himself inside the jail, but that was too complex to create because I had to manage the death, and then I said, "Oh, why not create a way to be protected?" More simple, just by creating a shield. So it is the technical constraint that led me to create this system. This is an important view because it bring in the memory of a player the overall context, the view this view of a city allow to sorry Okay, so here, here is a guard, and I must lock the free door in front of him to make sure he will not shoot me. And here there is a kind of beam that is going up. If I destroy it, it will lock the door up there. So the elevator thing, well, I will talk about this later because we are going out. Oops. Okay, it is at that point that the frame become really important for me. Before it was just someone that was that helped the player at the beginning. But I felt attached to him, and I wanted to find him again as a designer and as a player. I hate this passage. You know, but it was not in the Amiga version, the Jet Steam. It has been Interplay wanted the game more difficult for the Super Nintendo, and so I added this. So this is another example of parallel action in front of a 2D plane, and it's really an advantage that we can use when we are creating a 2D game, is to exploit the background and the foreground to tell something. As you can see, there is less detail now, because at that moment of the development, yes, 1 year and a half of development to this point of a game, and I have a lot of to do again, a lot of more to do, and so I've decided to. To organize myself differently and to put less detail into the graphics, because if by not doing this, it would take maybe 2 years more, and it is hard to work alone such time. So okay. Oops. it's possible to destroy big objects. And it is typically something that is possible because there is some polygon. C'est pas vrai, mais alors. Bon, concentration. This place will be flooded later. Yes. Okay. Oh. This tentacle is very nasty because when you just arrive here, you go there and usually finish like this. Do someone know how to solve this situation where you have to go on the other side? And, but, well. So indeed you have to shoot here so that the creature fly, and then the creature is being eaten. This is one of the most difficult parts. I love the rush with the water, and because the cave, the pacing of a cave is relatively slow, and then here there is a big acceleration. Go. Okay. Our friend is alive. There's a very small detail here that probably no one saw. The palette, you see the character is becoming lighter under the light. And well, I spent some time to do this, but I'm not sure that was really useful. Okay. Maybe. Ah. Okay, I know. Ah, yes. Just to talk about the teleportation system. This is another example of limitation, technical limitation. That brings some nice originality. I wanted to change of floor in the jail, and having stairs were too complex to design, and I've decided to create a kind of teleporter, and this has been inspired by some manga where they use a lot of a strip to give the feeling of speed. And in the end, there is some stair. Whoops! Thank you. Do you know why Lester has red hair? It's because it's because I wanted him to don't look too much like me. Because I use rotoscoping technique, I don't want to project myself too much into the game, and it could have been easier to give him some black hair. And the red hair is nice because it really stands out from the background. That's a shame. Thank you for your patience.
How do you decide where to set the player back to? Sometimes like that it's quite a way back and other times it's just one screen.
Well, it's more the feeling. For example, here it's yes, I could have had a checkpoint on the bottom here. But okay, I forgot to take some air. But that's a sensible point, because choosing the checkpoint is not obvious, and it can be frustrating, but if it is too close, it can remove some salt. Oh god, no. I just press the shift key. Go. Did I move last time or not? I don't remember. I die with the first one or with the second one? Huh? Ah, okay. Thank you. Nom de Dieu, c'est pas vrai là. I can't imagine how many players hate me for this. That's probably the less interesting part of the game. I need your help. So, do you think I should go closer? Yeah? I go now? I go? You think? One more. Okay. Yeah, yeah? No? Yes, yes! Thank you! And yes. I'm terrible. Okay, now things will be more simple. Almost. Okay, so I have to destroy the light, so that the upstairs, our friend can progress in the tunnel. So this is, well, I'm going to give you the... It's a trick. Okay, this is one of my favorite puzzle because down there is a guard that you have to go through, and but he's really powerful, and you can't beat him, and it's very clear you can't beat him. And here there is a reflection of the guard below, so you have to, well, if I shoot. You can see the guard shooting, and you can see the reflection in the glass ball. So I have to wait the player being just at the center. And so this now we are going to it will be really a full rush and with a lot of rhythm and in the with a laser you will see, and I love to play with rhythm of small thing, small noise. It's another use of different plane. Here, so you're in the background of a setting, of a situation. So the player know what is happening, and then he can enter in the scene. Sorry? Exactly, it was this has been added in the for the SNES and PC version. And so I play with all the different gameplay elements I had, and trying to bring interesting situation. And I focus on the relationship between Lester and the friend. You don't have to shoot this guard. And, Sorry?
In the last screen, what was shooting at?
This one?
You mean? No, the last screen.
Ah, okay. Who is shooting?
Yeah.
I don't know. But yes, I mean it's a guard, but just typically the player will be never touched by this, but it's just to bring some tension.
Okay.
So he locked the door, and he locked the door upstairs too. And because the guard upstairs is quite powerful, he uses a big ball of energy and and because the door is locked, I can prepare my shoot before being killed. The grenade create a hole. No comment. This is important to disable this energy line because it will allow to have a room in the dark later, and you will see why it is important. So, yes. So here. Because if it is not in the dark, they shoot you straight. So it opened the... I just want to show you something before. Well, this is the normal state. So we can go there. I'm opening the cage. It is the only time in the game where the player can dominate the situation. A little bit. Typically, on the screen before, all the lasers that are coming from the front are not dangerous, but it gives the sensation of being in a big battle with some guard walking in front too. Well, I should have polished the sound design and the animation for this. But I was exhausted as he was. Ready? Not forget to open this. So we are really close to the end now. And I had to work 16 hours a day for the last 3 months of the development. So that was, oh, quite cool. Don't worry. Thank you. It always makes me something special when I see this ending. Because it was so merged with finish the game, and what was so intense to finish it. So that was like the end of a marathon, and going out of the line, you know, with a winning line or something like this. But something more, yeah, very, very strange feeling indeed. And okay, now. Thank you for watching me playing. Yes, Interplay for the SNES version, really, they wanted their music. And they wanted to add music for the SNES. Well, I was not, I say okay, but they want to remove the music from the introduction and replace it by another. And I think that this music is perfect and it matches perfectly the picture. And so I had a big fight with Interplay, and it drove me really crazy because at this time we were exchanging not by mail but by fax. So this led to a big transatlantic fight by fax. And so after exchanging for several weeks, I've decided to use another strategy, which consisted in sending an infinite fax with something written on it. What's an infinite fax? It's a longest sheet of paper, so several sheet of paper, it's a long strip of paper, and when the where the beginning is stuck to the end, with an adhesive strip, and such that it loops around the fax machine endlessly. And of course, I did it when it was the night in Los Angeles, and and in the morning, it was a roll, it was not simple sheet of paper. So it was like we take some toilet paper and you put it like this. So, and unfortunately, it serves nothing. They don't want to move a bit, and Delphine Software, who was my publisher, said, no, you have to change it. Eric is the creator of the game. You don't have a right to impose this. And the game on SNES has been released with the original music. But yes, that was a funny moment. what can I say? I don't know if it is clear, but the whole game has been an improvisation process, and where everything has been done chronologically, and so that what has been done before was used as a foundation to build the rest of the game, and it's an important point because the most interesting thing in the game. I discover it while doing it really. It was not on mainly on paper. It was mainly because I start to play with a character and I thought, oh yes, that would be nice to have a friend. And what was not possible to create the old story from the beginning to the end. It's possible, but the process for this game was like this.
Did you ever try to dream, because it's become a very influential game, both for, you know, for game developers, other developers often quote Another World as one of their sort of the things that's inspired them. Did you ever dream when you were making it, or did you hope that it would become as influential as
the game? No, I had no idea at all, and I just did the game because I wanted to see a game like this, with this kind a game with very immersive, with no intrusive things, no HUD, I know that it was different, but that's it. That's all. Nothing. Any question?
And were there other games that inspired you to make that? What games have inspired you to do that?
Karateka had a strong impact on me when I discovered it on Apple II. Because in Karateka there is this cinematographic feeling, this mise en scène. I don't know if it is okay, cool. In Karateka you can you fight against different enemies that are sending by a samurai master, and it influenced me to create this game. And there is also Dragon Slayer for the technical side. Dragon Slayer influenced me to use polygonal technology, even if Dragon Slayer doesn't have polygonal technology, but because it has big character, it helped me to imagine that using polygon we could do the same with less memory. And but this is really the two main gaming influence. Yes.
Would you consider like remaking it now with the technology that's available? Mm. Would you keep it as a 2D platform?
I prefer to keep it like this. And to focus on new creation and new. I mean, this game I did it 20 years ago, and I just wanted to preserve it like this. Today I prefer to work on the more systemic game, so. It's a personal choice, and let's say for a remake or whatever, so it will demand a lot of energy. Even if, for example, it would be another studio who could do it,
yeah.
But it would not be possible for me to be aside this. And so for the next years, I really want to focus on a new creation. Yes.
Hello. 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 Is this a mic that turns off?
Hello. Ah, brilliant. That was good, wasn't it? Wasn't it? Yeah. Hang on, I haven't said clap yet. Stop it. I am sure that you would like to join me in thanking Eric for that. That was a game that's 20 years old, and that looked, let's be honest, better than a lot of the games that I've bought in the last 20 weeks. That game is older than some people in this room, I suspect. Sadly,
is
not
it
me.
Yes.
And it looks better than you too, as well. So, I think you should join me in thanking Eric again for a fantastic display of a fantastic game. So, thank you very much indeed. You may now clap.
Thanks for that. Thank you.